birthday, our buddy Brian B. from the Saturday Morning Isle of Plenty show on the Classics Radio Network. You can tune it in here at 2 hours of the best in progressive rock and roll.
Hello.
A lot of good backstories and a lot of good information that you share during your stuff. We were talking off the air, Brian, about some of the past shows that you've done.
Oh, yeah.
So what... when you first came to Classics Radio, and it's been...
2008.
Yeah, it's been since 2008. I think that you've got the seniority out of all the personalities and the people that are working here, right?
I think Eddie Millay might be the closest one to me.
Oh, okay.
Because he actually took over the Kindred Sanction show.
Yep.
When it came here to Class X from one of those other local...
Waif or Wobo, wherever Cynthia had it at.
Yeah, F, I think it was.
Wobo. Yeah.
So, so I think I may be one of the longer tenured DJs here at the station.
So you came to Bill Spry. We call him Mr. Bill. He is the president of Classics Radio, and we are a community radio station. We are by the people, for the people, and of the people. So you came in, Brian B., you came and you talked to him. What was the pitch? Do you remember what you said to him?
Yeah, actually, the show itself, the Isle of Plenty, actually goes back to days back in the mid-90s, believe it or not. I actually did the show back out on 88.7 WOBO.
Wow.
And actually had a friend of mine who was... he did a new age radio program, and back in the mid 90s, there was a guy who had an overnight rock and roll show that was on the air out of WOBO.
Okay.
And he was on the air Friday nights into Saturday mornings from midnight to 5 a.m.
All right. Wow.
So, yeah, he was...
No voice tracks either.
Oh, no.
That's live.
He was live.
Yeah.
He was live. And I had the first incarnation, I guess you have the first generation of the show, was actually it was a specific all Genesis radio program.
Okay.
Because I've been a huge fan of the group for over 30 years now.
All right.
And when I saw an ad online someplace that Bill was looking for, you know, DJs, and I thought, okay, well, maybe I'll go ahead and take the Isle of Plenty back on the air. Of course, by this time in 2008, it had been off the air for 11 years. So I was like, you know, I'll go ahead and approach Bill and see what happens, and pitch the idea initially to bring, you know, the Isle of Plenty Genesis version back to the airwaves.